throw some light on particularly B12 deficiency is currently so much in, and particularly vegetarian diet. I hear a lot about soil and this and that.
So B12 actually is one of those things where historically, I think what experts seem to believe is that when we lived in villages, right, if regardless of whether you were a vegetarian or a non-vegetarian, source of B12 fundamentally is soil bacteria, by the way. That's where it comes from. Okay. Some reason, we still don't know why, we seem to have, that is an essential vitamin and it comes only from soil bacteria. Maybe as a result of how mankind grew up, growing plants, agriculture, it's part of that, right? And in historically, we would harvest the stuff from the soil, it wouldn't be 100% washed. Some of that soil will be there in the vegetables and root vegetables, and from that you're going to get that bacteria that will produce the B12, or the B12 will already be there, right, in the soil and so on. So we never had much of a problem as a serious problem, right? Again, to be fair, the other thing to remember is that it was only in the 20th century we were able to diagnose vitamin deficiencies. Earlier, we didn't have a name for it. Somebody would have a big throat, we didn't know it was a thyroid, right, with thiamine deficiency or a iodine deficiency or what, sorry, iodine deficiency and so on. And when we discovered that it was an iodine deficiency, then the solution to the problem was to add iodine to salt, because then it's an easy fix, right? See, in the 1960s, around 1950s and 60s, people in India forget that so many kids in the Himalayan region, particularly UP and that region where they are far away from the sea, so the soil doesn't have iodine, and they're also vegetarian, so iodine doesn't come from vegetarian sources. They would have, so many kids have the thyroid problem, and that also impairs cognitive development and all that. No? So the government ran a program to promote iodized salt. They were only eating the senda namak, which has no iodine, all of that, right? So iodized salt, and we fixed that problem, right? So people are completely forget that while historically we dealt with deficiencies, not by knowing the science of it, but through practice knowledge of, if I have these things in my region, as my grandmother told me, we have survived so long, so it will work. So that's why we find that dal chawal mixes gets you all the amino acids, right? Having palak gets you all the B vitamins, right? Squeezing lime at the end gets you the vitamin C, right? Drinking milk gets you all the fat soluble vitamins. And so in that sense, you broadly got it. And plus, you're living in a village and you're harvesting the stuff from the soil, you got vitamin B12, right? So that's the general hypothesis, that even if you're a vegetarian, you probably got it. And you also get a tiny amount from milk. Dairy anyway, right? It comes only from animal sources. So, only now are we able to do large scale testing, and now we know 76% of the Indian population is not getting enough protein. 76, a huge percentage of the population is vitamin D deficient. Half the population is vitamin B12 deficient. And again, this has become particularly more of a concern because we are not harvesting muddy vegetables from the soil anymore. We are not drinking water from earthen pots and those kinds of things. We are living in hyper hygienic environments where we don't have access to those soil bacteria or those natural ways we've somehow gotten, right, without causing too many problems. So now that you know it, there's an opportunity to fix that problem, right? If you're a vegetarian, the only way to really fix that problem first is you get tested, because see, some people are able to absorb enough vitamin B12 from milk and other things, cheese, right? These are all good sources, decent sources, right? But some people are not. So, if you are deficient, just take a supplement. Ask a doctor, see if you are deficient, get yourself tested, then take a supplement. You don't need much.